Hello everyone, this is meteorologist Dave Snyder at the National Weather Service Forecast Office TV Desk in Anchorage, Alaska. This is the climate outlook for Alaska during the period of November 8 to 14, 2013. After somewhat cooler weather in many locations, sea ice is filling in along the Beaufort Sea coast and along the shores of the Chukchi Sea. It's expected that ice will increase in Kotzebue Sound, and places like Shishmaref will begin to have ice along the coastline. You can see the latest outlook from the ice desk at the address on your screen. Sea surface temperatures continue to drop, right in line with decreasing daylight. That means more ice in more of the usual places. During this past week, windstorms and periods of heavy rain brought damage and flooding to parts of south-central Alaska, and for the early mid-November period, a similar pattern will continue for south-central and southeast Alaska, while the north slope and the west coast may shift into a stormier, more active pattern. With increased chances of storms moving along the north and west coast, there's room for a big storm to develop in this pattern. Though it's too soon to pin that down, you'll certainly want to follow your local forecast for that information. Increased activity in these areas could mean wetter than normal weather in the north, and increasing areas of snow cover are expected here. Along the southern coastline, heavy precipitation may be less likely, but it won't be a dry period. It's still a wetter time of the year. And with the current temperature outlook, establishing snow cover in southern low elevation locations like Anchorage will still be difficult. Warmer than normal weather will continue for most of Alaska, especially in the west coast. Daylight, snow cover, and sea ice for western and northern coastal areas is a key factor in Alaska's daily temperature for this time of the year. It will get colder, and increasing areas of snow cover will help it stay colder. Yet, with near-normal sea surface temperatures in the Gulf of Alaska, southeast locations like Sitka, Craig, and Juneau, just to name a few, may maintain a near-normal temperature level for this period. Keep in mind, that means it will be cooler than recent weeks, especially on nights with less cloud cover. With this pattern, a big storm could mean mostly rain south of the Bering Strait and even for parts of the interior. North of the Bering Strait, precipitation would be mixed, with mostly all snow on the north slope. And all coastal areas are still susceptible to windstorms. Remember, this is a broad look at a developing weather pattern 6 to 10 days in advance. This message isn't meant to forecast individual storms or day-to-day variations in your local weather. You should continue to monitor your local weather information from the National Weather Service forecast offices in Anchorage, Fairbanks, and Juneau in the coming days for watches, warnings, and any advisories. You can do that by heading to weather.gov, using your NOAA weather radio, or tuning into the Alaska Weather Show and your favorite TV and radio stations. Thanks for watching and sharing this with your Alaska friends on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. In Anchorage, I'm meteorologist Dave Snyder for the National Weather Service, Alaska Region.